Yes, he is. The esteemed mayor is here. Lots of things happening at the airport. The kids' kingdom's underway. National night out. So many things going on.
Lots going on, yeah.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Well, let's get started. Let's talk about what's going on at the airport. Somebody stopped me the other day and said, you won't recognize the airport.
And it's fun. I get out there every 3 or 4 weeks, so it's fun to see the incremental progress it's made between my visits. But yesterday, we dedicated the TSA screening area. We now have pre-check like you have in larger airports. It is a phenomenal layout. And so just to give viewers a sense, so prior to this opening, if you flew out on American or Allegiant, you went through the B gate.
Right.
And you went through a screening system there. If you went out on Delta or United, you went through the A gate and that. So those are both eliminated, and there's a centralized screening area right in the center there. So new state-of-the-art equipment, partners with TSA, airport security, and local law enforcement, really to make Evansville Regional Airport as safe and secure as possible.
So it's safety and security, but it's also speed, isn't it? Aren't you really moving people through there?
Yeah,
it's not that it's been a bad deal ever from Evansville.
No, it's easy to fly out of the Evansville Airport.
It really is.
Fun to talk to people who fly all over the world, and they, oh my gosh, we love your airport.
I know.
They're going to love it even more come October when all this is done. Doug Jost and his staff out there and the board have really done a nice job to vision how that can be set up for the future. We have about 220,000 people a year who fly out of there. And so, you know, roughly the same number that fly in. So, you know, almost a half million people in and out of that airport every year. So it's important that that airport is really set up for a modern day business traveler or leisure traveler.
But still that same convenience that we have because
Absolutely.
You can fly in and out
yeah.
so easily
Absolutely.
And get to the airport so easily. Kids Kingdom.
Mickey's Kingdom.
Mickey's Kingdom
the new name.
Is coming up.
Yeah, so we're taking Traveling City Hall outside tomorrow night, and we'll be right at the tip of the museum parking lot where Mickey's Kingdom will be constructed. So think about this. When Kids Kingdom was built in the early 2000s, they needed 1,300 volunteers to construct it.
Yes, that was then.
That was then.
And this is now.
All I know is we need more than that because it's a bigger, badder playground, and it's going to be, I've seen the design. It is phenomenal. The vendor and our Parks Department leadership under Brian Holtz, they went out and talked to kids at 6 schools to get their feedback, the people who are going to use it the most.
Right,
so
right.
Two of the best features, and there are many great features. One, it will be accessible for kids of all ability. And second of all, there will be views of the river from some points in the playground.
So and it's the splash pad. I mean, you know, my grandkids are as excited about that as water play or anything. It's going to be great. If you haven't seen the design, it's pretty cool.
The build week, and we do want people to come out tomorrow night to learn how they can volunteer and sign up. But the build week is in September. It will take a few days to sort of set after it's all constructed, and we really anticipate opening it in early to mid-October this year.
Oh, really?
This year.
Oh, my goodness, you caught me up there a little bit. That's exciting. That's exciting. Well, let's talk about the Greenway Corridor.
The High Rail Corridor, this is really a cool update and expansion of the Pigeon Creek Greenway. This goes up the old Indiana High Rail, which is an abandoned rail line that runs on the west side of 41. This new 2.5-mile stretch will go from Riverside Drive to Walnut.
So it's a
nice stretch. It has it will have 10-foot-wide paths. Benches along the way with solar lighting, so it will be a safe path. So that will add to the 6.75 miles of greenway that we have now. Again, connectivity connects us from Riverside to Walnut and greater access to parks all along the city.
That sounds like it's going to be really great. And Clean Evansville, Saturday, August the 4th.
Yeah, the first Saturday of every month, we're out picking up trash.
If your wife leaves any out there.
Yeah. Exactly. She's
out there every morning.
She picks it up every morning, but we're out on the first Saturday of every month. We'll be in the Rochelle Landers Pool, Lincoln School area. From 8 to noon, we move it up a little bit in the summer months, try to avoid the heat. But this is a great way We get all kinds of community organizations. We get church groups, scout groups, neighborhood groups. Just people want to come out and pick up trash. If you can't join us for 2 hours, join us for an hour or 90 minutes, whatever you have. We supply the gloves and the bags, and it's actually a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun. A lot of team building there.
Absolutely.
Well, we've got about 5 seconds, so let's talk about National Night Out. When's it going to be and where?
National Night Out is the August 7th, which is a big week. It's also the week we dedicate the Stone Family Center for Health Sciences. But the 7th from 6 to 8 at Westwood Park, and it's a big family friendly event. You can learn all about what our public safety agencies do, EPD, EFD, the Sheriff's Department, and all the specialty units that we have within those departments out meeting and greeting, and lots of food and lots of fun.
Thank you so much for coming.
My pleasure. Yeah.
All this exciting news in our city.
We got it all done.
And now we have a very big dog coming up. A very big dog right there. Divas and Dogs, there they are.